An advertiser's audience tab is where you can create and manage audience lists for that advertiser. The audience's page is divided into three tabs: general, custom, and combined. Other videos in this series walk through how to build each type of audience list, so for now, let's take a high-level look at what each of these audience options provides. The General tab is a library of all the first-party audience lists that your advertiser can access, including those ported in through a data management platform. This list shows the audience name, the audience type, which can be tag-based, unknown, or customer match, and display size, which is important to ensure that your audience has enough reach so line item spend won't be limited. Typically, any audience with a display size smaller than 2,500 isn't worth targeting because it may be difficult to spend your entire budget on such a small audience. Any audience under 1,000 won't show the specific number of people in the list and likely wouldn't spend your budget at all, so be sure to check this column when deciding which audiences you'd like to target. The important thing to keep in mind about first-party audiences is that they are one-to-one with a floodlight activity. Before you create audience lists, you must first create floodlight activities in a linked Campaign Manager 360 account. Those activities will then port over to DV360, which may take up to 4 hours, and you can assign them to campaigns. Once those floodlight activities are live, you'll be able to see users start accruing under first-party audience lists. To create a new first-party audience, navigate to the General tab of the All Audiences page and click the New Audience button. There are 4 kinds of first-party audience lists you can create. Let's start with a quick overview of each kind. First, we have combined audiences. These lists allow you to combine existing audiences to create a new one. Use a combination of first-party, third-party, Google in-market, and/or Google Affinity audiences to create new personas for more specific audience targeting. Next, we have tag-based audiences. These audiences segment users into different pools based on custom variables attached to a single floodlight pixel. You can use tag-based audiences for planning, remarketing, and reporting based on various segments of larger audiences. You can also create a YouTube users list. These remarketing lists include users who have interacted with your YouTube videos, ads, or channels. The final option is a customer match audience list. Customer match lists are created from your first-party data that you upload into DV360. Since they rely solely on first-party data, they're a great strategy to employ in the wake of third-party cookie deprecation. Back on the All Audiences page, let's take a look at the next tab, Custom Lists. Here, you can use contextual signals, websites, and different topics to source users into custom intent or affinity lists that you can apply to your campaigns. Finally, we have the Combined tab. This is just another place where you can create and manage combined audience lists.